Hello students, welcome back once again in English literature class. This is Uma Vidushi, your English teacher, and this is the second part of the video where I was explaining you the stanzas of the poem After the Storm, which is written by William Wordsworth. So let's recapitulate quickly the introduction of the author. So this poem is written by William Wordsworth, who was an English romantic poet and was born on 7th April 1770 in United Kingdom and was died on 23rd April 1850. He has written many poems like I Wander Lonely as a Cloud, Lines Written a Few Miles Above Tintree Abbey, The Prelude, and many more. So he was one of the most famous poet in English literature. Now let's see the explanation of stanza number 2. William Wordsworth loved nature, and like much of his work, his poem too praises the beauty of the nature. In stanza 2, you will also find that how beautifully he describes the atmosphere of the place after the stormy night. As he says that one, all the creatures, all the birds who love the sun has came out from their home, holes to take the warmth of the sun. So as the sky was rejoiced by the morning's beauty, morning's sun, the grass is also very bright with all the raindrops around. And there are some uncultivated land which is now completely filled with green grasses after the rain. And the different creatures like hare, rabbits, hares, right? They are just running, jumping from here to there, and they are just enjoying the place. The poet has personified various aspects of nature. And thus he was able to has enabled the reader to appreciate it in its different mood. He had here personified the hare like a person that who is enjoying the weather, who is taking participation in the race. Like it is written in stanza number 2 that the hare is running races. Running races, generally rabbit animals don't do racing, but here again the poet has personified it, and he is also explaining that how these hare, when they jump, they plunge out soil from their feet, which also makes the atmosphere looks beautiful, because when they plunge out those when they plunge out soil, the water droplets, it start shining on it because the sun rays fall on it. And with her feet, she from the placid earth. The rabbit or the hare raise a mist means small water droplets, and that start glittering in the sun. They are running, they are jumping, they are enjoying. So this way the poet has used his imaginary that make us feel that we all are becoming the witnesses of the scene. Does it enable us to establish a deeper connection with the nature? This is what the beauty of William Wordsworth. He tried to put all his imagination in his poem, and this enable us, means as the reader, to get a complete witness of the scene themselves. So this is the explanation of the second stanza. Now while reading this stanza, you will come across with few difficult words for which I have brought you the meaning of it. The first word is mirth. Mirth means joy, merriment, Here it is used for that rabbit, that how the rabbit was enjoying, how the hare was enjoying the place after the rain. The second word here is plassey, which means pools or puddles of water. Like after the heavy rainfall, the land was filled with some, the land has now become the pool of water, puddles of water, and where these creatures were enjoying a lot. The next here is raises a mist that and runs with her. Now the hare, the poet is describing about the hare's running feet, which throw up a small cloud of water drops that starts shining in the sunlight and follows the hare as it runs. The next word, the last word, is dot. Dot is actually the Latin word used for dust. So students, I hope you are able to now write down the complete summary and explanation of this poem very well. So that's all in today's video. In the next video, I will explain you the question answer of this poem. You can write the explanation of this poem by yourself even. So thank you so much. Note down these keywords in your copy, and I will see you in the next video with the question answer. Thank you.